It is too round on the top. It needs to be pointy.
Yeah, Starship. We need to make it more pointy.
Did you say that?
Mm-hmm.
Because of the movie?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Hold on.
This is Starship. Not the Starship, just Starship. And with twice the power of anything that has ever blasted off into space, it's the most powerful rocket humans have ever built. It's going to change our world in more ways than one. Not in 5 years, not in 20, today.
Welcome to Technality. I'm Alex, and here is a breakdown of everything you need to know about SpaceX's greatest achievement and why it's been all over the news lately.
On April 17th, 2023, 33 Raptor engines were supposed to spring to life, blasting the massive spacecraft off the SpaceX ground pad, better known as Starbase, and into outer space. But shit happens, and in this case, that shit was a frozen valve. Not all that uncommon for rocket ships. 3 days later, blast off, baby. The goal here was to make an almost full lap around the planet before re-entering the Earth's atmosphere near Hawaii. Unfortunately, Starship blew up, but not before valuable data was gathered. And that's what this is all about, because NASA astronauts have a date with the moon, and Starship needs to be fully operational for that to happen. But before we get to that, what is Starship? Well, we know it's crazy powerful, but what's cooking under that chrome hull, and why is it shaped like that?
Well, for starters, the iconic shape comes down to one thing, the 2012 Sacha Baron Cohen comedy, The Dictator.
Yeah, Starship, we need to make it more pointy.
Did you say that?
Mm-hmm.
Because of the movie?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Hold on. Hold on. But is it better to be pointier? Like, if it wasn't for the movie?
It's arguably slightly worse. But, like...
Elon Musk dropped close to $200 million when he co-founded SpaceX in 2002, the spaceflight company that, today, is valued at 500 times that. Long before Elon bought Twitter and became a polarizing figure, his goal was to get humans to Mars, as a backup homeworld humans can escape to if we mess the Earth up too much.
If something bad were to happen to Earth, you know, it could be like a meteor, like whatever destroyed the dinosaurs, super volcanoes, could be World War III, and then it would be good to have a second planet where civilization isn't wiped out.
That dream is still alive today. But before we get to Mars, we need to get to the moon. In November 2024, NASA is set to launch Artemis 2, crewed with the best of the best their astronaut program has to offer, to test the waters with a flyby around the moon and back to Earth. A year later, we'll see humans on the moon for the first time in over 50 years with Artemis 3, and Starship is a crucial piece of that interstellar operation, acting as a transfer point to and from the moon. Elon Musk's brainchild is monstrous. At almost 400 feet tall by 30 feet wide, it towers over every rocket that came before it. It's bigger than the Statue of Liberty.
But the real reason that Starship is going to revolutionize space travel is money.
The rocket's reusability reduces the cost of a launch while also making the ships, well, reusable, something rockets have never been able to do. And according to Elon, an orbital launch will eventually cost as low as $1 million.
Which is an absolute steal compared to the $152 million price tag they've had over at NASA. And then there's space tourism. There is a future where your kid gets called poor because they didn't spend spring break on a space cruise in outer orbit.
A potential partnership with Saga Space Architects is looking to transform Starship into the world's first space cruise. The Swiss designers have created a vertical space habitat that would fit perfectly within the shell of a SpaceX Starship. The 3D printed prototype, named Rosie, includes comfortable sleeping quarters, an office space, and workshop. And if the crew of the Starship decide to settle on the moon or Mars, the high-quality polymer is a strong defense against the harsh ultraviolet radiation they might encounter. Divided among 100 paying passengers, which is what you can fit in a Starship, that works out to a cost of about $20,000 a head.
Sounds expensive? Well, if you stop eating avocado toast today, you might have that saved up just in time to escape the climate purge of 2053.
You're going to be hearing a lot more about the Starship over the next few years, as timelines slowly turn into deadlines, and the moon becomes the next step in humanity's interplanetary conquest.
And that is it for this episode of Technality. Thank you so much for making it to the end, and I'll see you in the future.